I know you probably read the title and you're thinking, Alisa, the school is just around the corner. What are you talking about? The school might be just around the corner, but the summer is not over yet because we still have about a month of summer to go. Plus, in a lot of places, it's still hot to like September or mid-October. And here in Tennessee, it's no exception. So in this video, I would love to show you 10 really great projects for your summertime, clothing and accessories that you can complete in an afternoon. Quick and easy for all types of skill levels. So I truly hope that you enjoy this little video that will give you some inspiration and some ideas of the things to add to your summer wardrobe. So let's roll. Quick point here before we jump in. Throughout this whole video, you will actually see that there is a really good reason behind all of these projects being chosen for one particular video. And that reason is that all of them go really well together into this sort of really fun and easy to make summer capsule wardrobe. All of them. Well, besides one, there's one odd project that looks really fun, has incredible versatility, but it doesn't necessarily go with all of these items or with majority of these items. But you will be able to spot it a mile away, so I'm not worried about that. But the rest of the items actually go really well together. And you can put them in complete outfits, which is always very useful, so that way you don't have to sew a huge wardrobe of things. You can just sew a couple of really favorite pieces and mix and match them all season long. You know, I wasn't going to start with this item, but in Russian language we say that всё новое это хорошо забытое старое, which means that everything new is a well-forgotten past, and that's how I feel about this pillowcase top. I know that a lot of you have made this. I know that a lot of you were super successful at it, and also mixing it up, making it pretty, making it different, making it fun, adding a ruffle, adding this or that, because this design, let's face it, it's been around for decades, but it doesn't mean that it's a bad design, it doesn't mean that we cannot repeat it, and it also doesn't mean that we can add something new and interesting to it. So definitely have fun with it, and it comes together so quickly. Plus, in the original tutorial, I give you two options. One of them is how to draft it from scratch, and the other one is how to draft it by using a t-shirt. So that kind of cuts the whole process in half and makes it even faster. So definitely, if it's still hot where you live, this is the item to go for. Interestingly enough, I didn't plan it this way, but a lot of you made these shorts and that pillowcase top as a one set, as a combo. And some of you even wanted to make them into a romper. So combining two patterns together and making it into a one-piece set, which is a really cool idea. And I always urge you to look beyond what you see as a line drawing, to look beyond what you see in my tutorials, and to really have fun with your creativity. And you guys don't fail to surprise me time and time again, which is just, it truly is amazing. Now, these shorts are actually culotte shorts, meaning that they don't sit too tight to the body. They actually sit a little bit away from your bottom part, giving you really nice amount of within your legs, so they're not too tight. They're perfect for lightweight materials with really good drape, something that is going to give you a lot of room to move in and feeling really comfortable. And you can also complete these in an afternoon, really easy. And should I add this to the list, they have pockets, and I show you in the tutorial how to draft pockets as well. So definitely have fun there. Where are all of the tutorials, Alisa, you might ask? Well, all of the tutorials will be linked in the info box below right underneath this video for your convenience. Super easy to find, and then I will also leave them as a playlist at the end of this video, so that way you don't have to go anywhere, you just click on it and all of the videos just show up for you, so that way it really is easy and straightforward. Now, this really quick and easy project you might not have seen yet if you're new to the channel. And if you are, thank you so much, welcome, and I truly hope that you're enjoying your time here and that you're enjoying all of the videos that are available for you. And if you've been with me for a while, thank you so much as well for sticking around, for coming back week after week and just being so wonderful. And this top, if you remember, was a really big hit last summer. It's a really simple peasant top. Two pattern pieces, the front and the back. The short shoulder and the front neckline and the back neckline are gathered, and it creates a really effortless silhouette. It goes really well with everything. You can tuck it in into a skirt. You can wear it on top of jeans or shorts. You can even extend it into the dress and make cinched waistline here with elastic. So possibilities are endless. And should I tell you that it also comes together in an afternoon? So it really is straightforward, simple, and everybody can do it. Now, one thing that I really love about this peasant top is that it actually has shoulders over here. So it has, you know, an actual shoulder, not like a strap, because it burns so easily during summertime. And I don't know, the sunscreen just doesn't stay up, or I forget to put it on. Well, you know. You know how it is. So if you're like me, you might want to consider like a really easy breezy summer cardigan that can also transition you into the fall wardrobe as well. And I do have just the perfect tutorial for you. And the really cool part about this really easy breezy cardigan is that it literally consists out of straight lines. So it is perfect if this is one of your first projects, maybe like not the very first, but one of your first projects. It is also really great when you're using lightweight fabrics, because when you're working with straight lines and lightweight fabrics, there's nothing better. Because you know how it is sometimes with lightweight fabrics, they slip and slide all over the place. So when you're working with straight lines, it does make your life so much easier. And I also found this really cool hack where you take this really easy breezy summer cardigan and you put it together and you take a scrunchie and you tie the ends and then you tug the ends in, and ta-da! Now you have a shirt instead of a cardigan. And those cardigans are really loved because they're a lot lighter than, for example, a cardigan like this. And the reason why I'm wearing this right now is because I film in the basement and it's really cold here. Outside, this would be way too warm, way too stuffy. So this one is really perfect. And yes, it's made from the same fabric as the pillowcase top, because I did buy like 3 yards of it. Alright, so let's take a look. We have shorts, we have tops with straps, we have tops with an actual shoulder, we have a cardigan for summer, and right now, let's talk about skirts. And the skirt that I'm just about to offer to you, of course, is a circle skirt. It is such an effortless option for summer and for any season, really. It really is a versatile piece. And this circle skirt, which is actually a semicircle skirt, comes together in no time, because I'll show you a method how you don't have to count out the pi formula. Anyway, just watch the tutorial, you will see what I mean. And it has elastic at the waist, and you can make it any length, you can make it floor length. Right now, maxi is really in fashion, so you might wanna do a couple of those for yourself. I know that I made one for myself, and I also made one for my little one. Not to mention that if you take this peasant top, of course not the same color, but if you take the style of a peasant top or a pillowcase top, and you pair it together with your circle skirt, it makes a perfect little outfit. Now, there is a wardrobe item, or accessory, I should say, that definitely made its way back into fashion this season, or maybe even last season. Well, you know what I'm talking about. It's, of course, the bucket hat. And I do have a very detailed step-by-step tutorial on how to draft your own bucket hat by using just one simple measurement, and that is the circumference of your head. So whether you want to create it for yourself or for your entire family, it really is such a versatile project that you will wear not only this year, but also the next year and the year after that. And even if it goes out of fashion, you know, there's nothing better than protecting your head from sun, whether you're outdoors, in the garden, swimming, or whatever else you're doing. You definitely might want to make one for yourself. And it really is great to use for your fabric scraps as well. You can even make it patchwork style. Why not? Just have fun with it. Now, this one actually has been your favorite. That's exactly right. You guys have made it in so many different variations. I've seen it as a beach cover-up, I've seen it as a dress, I've seen it as a top, with the belt, without the belt, and of course, I'm talking about a simple circle top. And wow, you guys amaze me every time when you come up with something super fun and super incredible just by using these really simple and straightforward sewing tutorials. So definitely keep that one in mind. It comes to together in an afternoon. You only need a couple of measurements, and it really is almost like a no-fail option, and it looks so elegant. I truly think it does look really, really fun, really elegant, really ladylike. And again, you can make it as a cover-up, as a dress, as a blouse. Possibilities are endless. Now, I gotta say, there's nothing better than making a garment out of one piece of fabric. Literally, out of one piece of fabric. Like, this is one pattern piece, both front and back together. There's no shoulder seam, which makes it for a really easy assembly. It fits really nice, and a lot of you really, really loved it. I've seen versions made into a dress. I've seen versions a little bit longer, a little bit shorter, with elastic at the bottom. I mean, you guys really took it to the next level. So definitely take a look at this really easy summer top, and I truly hope that you enjoyed it. You can make it out of a variety of fabrics. The key is to go for lightweight fabrics that are going to give you really nice, elegant gathers here at the sleeves, because you don't want anything super too bulky, or maybe you do want something with pronounced gathers, something that's going to give you that extra volume, maybe a little bit of touch of avant-garde. Who knows? Maybe that's your style. So definitely do what makes you happy, because sewing is all about that. This one actually goes really well with a circle skirt as well, and with the shorts as well, of course, different color. Let's talk about t-shirts, because living through the summer without a t-shirt, it's almost impossible. Or is it possible? I don't know. Do I wear a lot of t-shirts during summertime? I actually do. I mean, they're comfortable. They're easy to sew. That's right. They're easy to sew. I do have a really neat hack for you guys. And you can really play around with the style, with the shape. You can make them close fitting. You can make them looser. You can make them boyfriend style. You can even make them into a t-shirt dress. Yes, so a lot of options, a lot of variations, and I do have a really fun and simple t-shirt project for you guys that is also only two pattern pieces, the front and the back. So the sleeve is all in one together with the body, so you don't have to worry about inserting sleeves, because I know it might be one of those bottleneck situations where you get to the almost the end of the project and bam, you have to insert a sleeve and the sleeve just doesn't turn out. Well, in this case, it's all solved because there's no sleeve. I mean, there is a sleeve, but it's all together in one pattern piece. You know what I'm saying? So this is this project, and I truly hope that you will enjoy it, because it is such an easy one as well. Besides, I do have an additional video on how to sew knits on a sewing machine, so that one really comes in handy, especially if you're a little bit cautious around sewing knits, or maybe you haven't tried that before. Not to mention that the t-shirt goes really well with shorts, goes really well with a breezy cardigan, goes really well with a circle skirt. I mean, what not to like? And last but not least is this bandana. And the really beautiful thing about it is that you don't have to have an afternoon to make it. You don't even have to have 1 hour to make it. It really comes together in 10 minutes. I timed myself. It comes together so quickly, you have no idea. It's perfect for scrap busting. It's perfect to use instead of bucket hat if you don't have enough time to make a bucket hat, or maybe you just don't have big enough fabric scraps for it. You can make this bandana, and as I said, it's double duty. Wear it during summertime to protect your head from the heat and from the sun, and then wear it around the house to get, you know, hair out of your eyes, and while you're doing chores around the house, or maybe working or working out or whatever else is on your agenda. And yes, I also made one for myself and one for my little one. As I promised, the playlist with all of the tutorials will be right over here, so click right over here, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Happy summer sewing while the summer is still here, and I'll see you very, very soon. Bye!